The broadcast is now starting. All attendees are in listen-only mode.
Very good afternoon, everyone. So the webinar will start little shortly. Maybe give us another 2-3 minutes. Let all the attendees join. A very good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the Hilti webinar on complete connection design for steel to concrete connection. I thank you everyone for joining this webinar. I myself, Chandrasekhar Adityan, manager for structural applications. I'll be your moderator for this webinar. So before we begin, here is a quick guide to the webinar platform. All attendees are muted. If you have a concern, please type it in the chat box. Let's look at the agenda of the webinar. So the agenda is, there is an introduction and an end-to-end workflow for a base plate application, the pain points we see in the steel to concrete connection design, and the innovation, Profis Engineering, a software demo, and question and answers. So let me introduce our speaker for this webinar. I want to welcome Karan Khanna, Manager Software and Services. Before I hand it over to Karan, let me introduce him to you. Karan joined Hilti about 2.5 years ago. He looks after all of our softwares. Prior to joining Hilti, he was working at a structural consultant and has been involved in designing of many building projects. He holds a master degree in structural design and a bachelor's degree in civil engineering. So let me hand over the mic to him so that he will take up the stage.
Thank you, Chandru. A very good afternoon, everyone. I again welcome you all to this Hilti webinar on complete connection design for steel to concrete connection. So we'll start this webinar by understanding a base plate application. So here is a slide which shows you end to end what are the steps that need to be followed for executing a base plate or an end plate or a steel plate application. So basically, first we start by identifying what is the application. Why do we need to do an anchoring job for connecting steel to concrete connection? To give you a few examples of application, we can have a connection of beam to a structural concrete column. We can have steel staircases which are being fixed to my beams. We can have a mezzanine floor connection. We also have some architectural elements that get connected to my building. Other applications, if I talk from an industrial point of view, could be an equipment fixing or a machine fixing, where you might need to fix your steel plate to your concrete. Upon understanding of the application, the next step is design. So all our structural connections must be thoroughly designed, and there are different solutions that are available to do a complete design for a base plate application. Design will enable us to select the right anchor for our application. Our softwares enable you to select the right anchor for the right kind of application. Once the design is complete, we move on to the execution part. And the first step there is to scan my base material. So Hilti offers end-to-end solution for a base plate application. We can scan the base material through our available scanners, which will help us to identify the right location for drilling. The idea of scanning is to avoid hitting a rebar. After scanning the base material, be it concrete or be it masonry, masonry does not have a reinforcement, so we don't need to scan there. We move on to installation. Under installation, there are different steps that are involved. So we will have first drilling of the hole. Then in case of chemical anchor, we will have cleaning. In case of mechanical anchor also, we'll have cleaning of the hole. Then we will install the anchor, be it chemical or mechanical. And then there will be installation of plate and final torquing of our anchors. To check the installation, we also have on-site testing available, which will enable you to check if the installation has achieved the right load values for the anchor. In this webinar, we'll focus our attention on design and design through our latest innovation, Profis Engineering software. In this month, we will also send out a newsletter which will cover all aspects of the base plate application. The webinar will focus mostly on design, but we will cover end-to-end all the steps in our newsletter, which will be coming to you in next week. Now let's talk about a steel to concrete connection. So as you can see in this image, this is a typical steel to concrete connection where a beam is getting connected to an RCC wall. There are different components in a steel to concrete connection. So we have the base plate, we have anchors, we have the steel profile, we have welds which are there to connect my steel components, and then in some cases we also have stiffeners. So far, Hilti has been supporting you with anchor designs. So I would like to understand from you through a poll how we are doing the design for other components. So we have a poll. Let me quickly pull up the poll for you. So there are three options. We have the option of in-house Excel sheet that you are using. The second option is manual calculation. And the third option is software that you might be using for a connection design. So I'll wait for you to respond. You can each select one option.
We are getting a good response now. So yes, almost more than 70% people have answered. Good.
So let's quickly wait for 5 more seconds for rest of the people to respond. Okay, let me quickly share the results of this poll with you. So as you can see, about 47% of the people are using in-house developed Excel sheets. 31% is doing manual calculation and 22% are using software. So if I tell you frankly, here the 80-20 rule applies very clearly. So you can see only 20% of the people are currently using a software for design of connections. And this was our finding. So when we did a market research, we found a similar thing, that most common method for design of connection is in-house spreadsheet and manual calculation. Some of the connections like non-structural connections may not be designed always, and engineering judgments might also be followed. And what we found for anchor designs is that either people are doing the anchor designs manually or they are using vendor provided anchor softwares like Hilti Profis Anchor for doing anchor designs. So we have another poll for you. Let me quickly pull up the second question. So the question is, have you used Hilti Profis Anchor software for designing post-installed anchors? And the options are yes, no, and the third option is I haven't heard about Hilti Profis Anchor. So I would like to know from you if you know about this software that we already have.
Yeah, we see a good amount of reply in this. Yes, almost 60%. Yes.
Yeah, the percentage is going up, Chandru.
There are a few who haven't heard about Profis Anchor as well. So, okay.
Okay, a couple of more seconds and we close. Almost 75% people have responded. Chandru, the results are amazing. We can see that more than 50% of the people have used our Profis Anchor software.
Amazing.
This looks really good. 37% people have not used it, but have heard about it. And only 7% of the attendees have not heard about Profis Anchor. This really makes me happy, Chandru. So moving on, since most of you have used Profis Anchor, you must have seen this. You must have seen this design report from Hilti. So you can see this is the design report that you get. Just one second, I'll quickly fix. There is some problem. Yeah, I think it's fixed. So this is the design report from Hilti. I want to draw your attention to one particular statement here, which says user is responsible to ensure a rigid base plate for the entered thickness with appropriate solutions, stiffeners, etc. So we have specifically highlighted the word rigid base plate. So let's understand what a rigid base plate means. So a rigid base plate is one which has infinite bending thickness and does not deform under bending. So let's quickly look at an image. So let's say we have a compression force on our base plate, then all the forces would be transferred from the base material to the concrete, from the base plate to the base material in case of compression. In case of tension, the loads would be resisted by my anchors. And in case I have a rigid base plate and a bending moment, then there would be a linear bending moment diagram. What I'm trying to explain with this image is that if I have a rigid base plate, the plate itself will not undergo any stresses or deformation. All the forces and stresses would be transferred to my base material, that is concrete in case of compression, and to anchors in case of tension. However, rigid base plate is a concept which exists only in the books. It is pure theory. Practically, 100% rigid base plates are not at all possible. So what we have practically is either a semi-rigid plate or a non-rigid plate. And you can see from the image that when I have a non-rigid plate and a tension force is applied on the plate, there is some additional stress which develops at the corners. Similarly, in case of a compression load, there are some additional stresses that are developed under the profile or the member. The same behavior can be observed in case of one-way bending, where you can see some additional stresses on the corners. And also in case of two-way bending, again, if my plate is non-rigid or semi-rigid, some additional forces are developed. Let me also tell you, if you remember a few slides ago, I showed you a warning what we have on Profis Anchor, that we are designing the anchors with the assumption of rigid base plate. So all the formulas that have been derived for calculation of forces are based on rigid base plate assumption. So what will happen if my plate is non-rigid? So the design codes that we have, be it IS code, be it Euro code, or be it American code, they require us to check the rigidity of the plates. Why does the code say that? The answer is, plates generally are thin elements which can deform under bending. And this bending can result into underestimation of anchor forces. So the rigidity of the plate must be verified. To give you the reasons, like I already explained, the anchor forces are based on rigid base plate assumption. So if I don't provide a plate which is completely rigid or at least close to rigid, then these formulas of anchor calculations are not applicable. Now we understand that in case of bending, my neutral axis might change. A change in neutral axis will change the lever arm. And a change in lever arm might lead to increase in forces on my anchors. If you remember the earlier images that I showed you for tension loads, when we have a tension load on a plate and my plate is not completely rigid, there are some additional compression stresses that are developed at the corners. Now, these additional stresses can increase my prying force on the anchor. And also an effect of the non-rigid plate can be additional deflection or deformation, ultimately leading to a failure. Now, I know you cannot respond back to me, but this is where generally I ask people if they have seen a base plate failure or not, or a steel plate failure or not. But let me show you some images of plate failure. So if you look at the first image, you can see that this image shows a tension failure. You can see the bent shape of the plate and you can see how the anchors have failed. This particular image below it, the second one, is tearing of the plate. It was a thin plate which has torn. This central image, this big one, is a compression failure tested in a lab. So you can see all these markings made by. And the fourth one is a bending failure. You can see how the profile has bent out of shape. It has turned. And the last one, you can see the idiot who was doing the installation even forgot to put anchors in that. I think all of you would agree that connection failure is an important risk. We cannot risk failure of the connection. And you would agree that a connection failure might risk human life. Now, there are several parameters that influence base plate rigidity. We have the base plate size, we have the influence of stiffeners, we have base plate thickness, even anchor size, anchor type, and anchor position can have a significant impact on the rigidity of the plate. The rigidity also depends on the size of the profile and definitely the thickness. Now, what we saw during our market research is that an approach that considers load distribution for real life cases was missing. We could not take into account the base plate flexibility. We could not consider the impact of stiffeners on base plate, and an approach covering all anchor arrangements was missing. Now, here we are addressing the pain points. Now, if we look at the structural design workflow, and I have taken two people into this workflow. We have the structural engineer and we have the detailer or draftsman. So any project that we have starts with an architectural drawing, based on which we create some structural drawings, be it GA drawings or framing plans as we call it. Next, we have, based on these structural drawings, we do some structural modeling and analysis. And then finally, we do the structural detailing. Once my structural detailing is done, let's move on to the connection design. So we do anchor design, we do base plate design, we do stiffener design, and we do a weld design. What I have understood from talking to people in India is that once our design is complete, the engineer does hand sketches of the design and hands it over to the detailer or draftsman. Based on these hand sketches, connection detailing is done by the draftsman, and finally, bill of materials may be prepared. Now, let's call these four steps as complete connection design. So, what I want to know from you is another poll. I want to know from you, how much time does it typically take you to do a base plate stiffener and a weld design?
I see almost 50% people have voted. So quite a good response. Yes. And let us wait for another 5 seconds max. Let us see the other polls as well. Good. Okay. So let us proceed then.
Yeah. So almost 70% of the people have responded. Let me quickly share the responses with you. So almost 70% people say that it takes about 2 hours to do a design. And 15% say it takes 2 to 4 hours. And 15% also say that it takes sometimes around more than 4 hours to do a complete base plate design. Now, similar was the finding from our side. So complete connection design calculation, and I have taken a conservative number here, almost takes 60 minutes. And if any of you disagree with the numbers that I'm going to show, you can definitely put it in the chat box. Hand sketches takes about 15 minutes by the engineer. The person who is drafting may take up to 45 minutes for doing the complete connection detailing. And bill of materials, generally prepared by some other team or in a few cases by the draftsman itself, takes around 30 minutes. Now, this total time comes to about 2.5 hours for complete connection design. And you can see in each step, one person is involved, be it engineer or the draftsman. And because of this manual integration, this process is time consuming. And I think, and please don't mind, but I think this is somewhat unproductive to spend 2.5 hours on one connection for the complete detail. So the first challenge what we saw was rigid base plates. The second challenge what we saw was time consuming process to do a base plate design. And now let's look at the third challenge. What as a structural consultant myself, I have also faced. So what happens is, as one consultant, let's say I'm a consultant and Chandru is also a consultant, I might have one way of putting my Excel sheet, the calculations, one way of doing manual calculation. The other consultant might have a different Excel sheet or a different way of doing manual calculation. So in the market, if we see, there are a lot of Excel sheets that are available for base plate design. So currently, there is no similarity in design methodology. Although we are using the same design codes, but the way we have prepared our Excel sheets is somewhat different from the other Excel sheet. So when my calculation goes to a peer review consultant or a proof consultant, or I am acting as a proof consultant and I get some Excel sheet from a different consultant, it takes me some time to understand how the calculations have been done. And I spend time analyzing whether the formulas he has put are right or wrong. And we have this practice of sharing PDF files, so we are not able to see the exact formulas. We check it with our own Excel sheet. The values don't match. There is a lot of mail exchange. There are lots of phone calls, con calls, WhatsApp messages. And all of this leads to a lot of rework. And then it again becomes time consuming. So the question is there a better way of designing connections? And now I can proudly say the answer is a big yes. Let me show you what our new innovation, Profis Engineering software, can do for you. So I would like to introduce you the software by telling you one good thing, that it is going to be a cloud-based software. No more desktop. So this is going to be a cloud-based software which will have increased project collaboration by project sharing. During the demo, I'll explain what I mean by project sharing. No more software updates would be required. What I mean by that is, it's not that we will not work on the software and update it. The thing is, since it is a website basically that you go to access the software, every time you visit this website, it is a fully updated version of the software. There can be no data losses because the data is securely stored on cloud. You have the flexibility to work from anywhere. And I don't mean flexibility only in terms of location, but also in terms of device. So you can use the software from your laptop, from your desktop, even from your tab or mobile phone. And it has autosave mode. So you do not need to worry if you saved the last change or not. Now, what are we going to do with this Profis Engineering software? First of all, we easily model the connection, including the base plate, stiffener, anchor, weld, and the modeling itself will save you a lot of time. Then we design the full base plate, be it under static or be it under seismic condition. And once you have done a design, you can get a comprehensive report of your design. So it will be a detailed design report of about 15 to 20 pages. And this design would be performed using CBFEM. What does CBFEM mean? CBFEM means component-based finite element method. Now, what we are doing is we are using finite element method to determine the stresses that will come on my base plate, on my stiffener, on my anchors. And the way of modeling is concrete is modeled as a compression spring. We are modeling the anchor as a tension spring. And steel elements are modeled as shell elements. All the steel elements are modeled as shell elements. Moving on. Now the resistance verifications will be done. For anchor, we will verify what is the tension and the shear capacity and what is the combination of tension and shear. For base plate, we will be checking the stresses as well as the strain values. For welds, we will be checking what is the stress and what is the utilization of the weld. And we will also check what is the bearing stress. So what is the stress that is developed in the concrete, that is developed in concrete under the base plate. So we will be checking for all the components of the connection. And here I have a quick question for you. I just want to know. Just one second, let me pull up the question for you. Which design code do you use for base plate stiffener and weld design? Is it Indian code? Is it European code? Is it American code? Or any other code that you might be using?
Right, we are getting good response now. Okay. If you have any questions, please put it down after this poll. Almost 70% people have voted. So let's wait for another 5 seconds. Yes, it's good to go. So the results are almost 70% are using Indian standard codes. Great. And the other codes are almost 30%. Good. So,
yeah, this is, I think, as per our expectation.
Yes.
Being in India, most of us are actively using Indian standard codes, but some of us are also doing projects which are based outside India. So we are also using European and American codes. And this is the next point. So Profis Engineering gives you the flexibility of the code. You can choose if you want to use IS code or European code or American code. We have a list of codes available. In fact, let me tell you, Profis Engineering is being launched throughout the world. So any country we launch Profis Engineering in, we get the local design codes of that country. So we have New Zealand codes available. We have codes of Taiwan available. We have codes of Thailand, Russia, Canada, as well as Australia available in Profis Engineering. We take into account the stiffness of all the components to give you a complete finite element analysis of the connection. And this will give you a lot of reliability and accuracy in your calculations. I'm sure this next point I'm going to show you will really excite you. So what we have done now with our report is that we have included detailed formulas and clause number in the report itself. So if your proof consultant wants to check any value, how this value has been derived or how you calculated a certain component, the formulas are right there available in front of him.
This along with the clauses is also available. So where it has got from which code, all the details are completely available. So I think when a proof consultant is going to check on the details, he'll also have a better clarity on it.
Perfect. That's right, Chandru. And this will ensure that our calculations are more reliable and they are easy to understand for everybody. Now, what we have also done is we have developed an integration with common structural softwares. So we have an integration with STAD Pro, with ETABS, with Robot, with SAP 2000. This will enable you to directly import load combinations to Profis Engineering. You don't need to manually enter the loads. You can simply select the node in the software and import directly the load combinations. What Profis Engineering will do is check for each and every load combination and then identify which is the critical governing load combination, which will enable you to save time, minimize our assumptions. That is, we are not assuming or ourselves calculating which is the critical load combination. The software will do it for us, and it will also help us to increase our accuracy. Now, what we have also developed is an integration on the final output side. So once your design is complete, we have a plugin with Tekla, so you can directly transfer your design directly to Tekla model. I understand most of us are still using AutoCAD, and AutoCAD is extensively used in the industry for detailing. So we have also developed an integration with AutoCAD. Now with AutoCAD integration, once your design is complete, you can directly transfer your design to AutoCAD. And I'm sure this will save time for your draftsmen, reduce manual sketching for the engineer, and even reduce mistakes. Just to avoid mistakes, I remember, Chandru, as a structural consultant, draftsmen used to come to me to get the drawings checked at least a couple of times. And I think with this direct export, we can at least eliminate one level of checking for the drawing, because it will be a direct software output that will come. Now, let me quickly show you an output from Profis Engineering. And the image that you see here is just for representation. The image will not directly look like this. So this is just to show you the view. So minus the dimensions, you will see everything that you see here. All the dimensions and the details, what we have done is we have put it in a beautiful table. So this is a table that will be generated in AutoCAD. You can even generate a PDF format of it, and your draftsman can simply copy paste this table. And Chandru, let me also tell you, the drawing part for the draftsman does not take a lot of time. It is writing the details on the drawing that consumes the most amount of time. And for this particular reason, we developed this feature. And you can clearly see, we will tell you the number of anchor, the name of the chemical, the anchor rod. If you look at base plate specification, so you see the size of the plate, the thickness, the material. This is European material, S235. You will also see the specification for concrete. So thickness, what is the grade of concrete, the profile, size, thickness, material, what is the type of weld we have taken, what is the throat thickness, what is the material, similarly for stiffeners. And to avoid confusion at site, what we have also included is the article number. Oh, Chandru, I forgot to tell the most important thing what we have done here. So if I remember correctly, almost more than 50% of the people are using Profis Anchor. And if you remember, with Profis Anchor, we were able to tell you the diameter of the anchor layout, the embedment depth. What we were not able to tell you was the length of the anchor. And you know why, Chandru?
Yes.
Why?
The thickness of the base plate.
Yes, correct. Right? So we did not know the thickness of the base plate with Profis Anchor. But with Profis Engineering, since I know the thickness of the base plate, I can also tell you the complete length of the anchor rod. And you can see here, I have mentioned M16 by 120. This is a software output that has come. Now, I hope you are not getting bored with the presentation. We'll quickly move on to the software demo. Just give me a couple of minutes more. So if you remember, we saw a workflow. Now, Profis Engineering becomes your one-stop solution for complete connection design, including the base plate, stiffener, weld, as well as anchor design. Profis Engineering can directly take inputs from your structural software, be it StatPro, ETABS, SAP 2000, and give you an output in AutoCAD or Tekla. The benefit and advantage with Tekla is that using Tekla, we can also generate the bill of materials. And all of this process can be done in a span of just 10 minutes. I hope that makes you excited. Now we will quickly move on to the software demo.
So whoever is having some questions or queries, please post them on the chat box so that we will answer you shortly after this session.
Okay, so let me quickly switch to the software. So the software is loading. We have put a beautiful Formula One animation till the time software loads. And you can see this is the home screen of the software. Now, what you can see is we have two modules, concrete fixing and masonry fixing. And you see this version over here, 3.0.56. So this is what I meant when I said the software will not require updates. So we are in the 56th version of this software. So it will keep on updating, but you will not need to do it. Every time you open it, it will be the fully updated version of the software. And I also spoke about project sharing. Just so that you can organize your designs properly, what you can do is create a new project. Let's say I create a project by the name of webinar. So if I click on any design file, new file, it will be stored under webinar. Let's say I click on concrete fixing. So a new design has opened up, and let me go back and show you. It is under the project webinar, and you can see this project file here. I also spoke about a share feature. So if I click here, click on share, I can enter the email ID of my colleagues and share this design folder with him. If my proof consultant is also using the software, I can directly share the complete project files directly with him through the software. Now let's go into the software. So this is the first screen that you see. Excuse me. So I will quickly explain to you the different tabs. So the first tab is the base material tab. Here we define the parameters of concrete. Next, we have the base plate tab where we define the parameters of my plate. We have the anchor tab for selection of anchor. We have the profiles tab for definition of profiles, and we have the loads tab. So first let me explain what can this software do. I have already told you Profis Engineering can do a complete connection design, but we have not taken the functionality of only anchor design away from you. So you have two options. You can either select rigid, that means I am assuming my plate to be rigid and I am only designing anchors, or I can select CBFEM. So CBFEM means I am doing the design of complete connection. Let's start with the first tab. What we have done is Indianize the software. So you will see Indian concrete grades M10, M15, M20, M25, right up to M60. So let's say we have M25 concrete. I can define the type of reinforcement, geometry. Let's say I want to make one of these edges infinite. So I can click infinity here. It becomes infinite. I can click infinity here. So basically all infinite edges means I'm doing a fixing on the slab. Then let's move on to the next tab. So we have the base plate. I can select the shape of the plate. Let's say I have a circular plate. I can simply click here and the plate becomes circular. I'll go back to a square plate. I can change the dimensions of the plate just by clicking on any of the dimensions. Let's say I have a 250 by 250 size plate. So I can simply click and change the plate size. And I can also define the material. So currently what you are seeing are European materials. I have the option to choose local steel material, that is Indian steel materials. Let's say we select Fe440. I can apply to all the steel parts. So I have defined my base plate. I have considered the thickness of 10 mm. Now coming to anchor, let's say I'm going with chemical anchor. We have also simplified the anchor tab quite a bit for you. So let's say you want a chemical anchor or an adhesive anchor. You can simply click on the filter here and all my mechanical anchors will disappear. We have other filters based on corrosion material. Let's say I click galvanized steel. So some of the options of stainless steel will go away. What is the kind of setting you want? What is the thread type of anchor? What is the head configuration? What is the installation type? So you can do quite a lot of filters to easily select the right anchor for you. And on the right, you will see the approvals. So all the approvals that this particular anchor has have been highlighted, like HY200 plus HZ has a seismic approval, so that has been highlighted. It has a stainless steel available, that has been highlighted. It is no cleaning required approved, safe set approved, that has been highlighted. So let's say I select this anchor, then I can easily select the diameter. Let's say I'm going with M12. You also see a button, view ETA approval. If you click this button, then it directly takes you to the ETA approval document of this particular anchor. So whichever anchor you select, you will be easily able to see the ETA approval for that. We have two options under embedment depth. So either if you have a restriction, you can yourself define an embedment depth. Let's say you want to limit it to some depth, or you can leave it on optimized embedment depth. And here the software itself will suggest the depth required for the anchor based on your loads. I hope I'm clear. If you have any questions, you can keep posting it in the questions tab. We will answer all the questions at the end. Now moving on to profiles. So you can see we have all Indian profiles available here. We have ISJB, ISMB, we have the channel sections, we have the T sections, we have angles, we have hollow square sections, rectangular, circular. You can select any of this. Let's say we want to have ISMB. So I select ISMB. Then as per Indian steel tables, you will see all the sizes here. Let's say I have ISMB 150. So I select ISMB 150. I can also define the type of weld. So for welds, we have either a one-sided fillet weld, right from inside or from outside, or a two-sided fillet weld. And we also have the butt weld option. So let's say we are going with two-sided fillet weld. Software will suggest a weld size based on the requirements. You can always increase it or decrease it, but it will not go beyond a certain value, which means that is the minimum weld size required, weld throat thickness required. Now for welds also, you can change the material in the similar way. I have kept the material as Fe440. And now I need to define the loads. So for loads, you can either do it through STAD Pro. Unfortunately, STAD and ETABS are two softwares which we do not have in our system. So I cannot show you the direct import feature right now, but we have videos available online which you can see how to do a direct import. There is a web application required which you can download from here, and then your ETABS or STAD Pro will directly connect to Profis Engineering. After the webinar, I'll share a link for the videos where you can go and see them. So let's say I have just a moment of 10 kilonewton on this plate. So you can see I have provided a moment. So all my parameters are defined. I'm doing a static load design. You can also do seismic and fatigue designs. Now let's press calculate. No worries, I'll just refresh. Now let's press calculate. Now you can see software is showing me two conditions. On my left, I have the equivalent rigid base plate. So this should be my ideal case. And on the right is whatever I have modeled, the calculation based on this. So I am currently looking at deformation, and you can see the deformation values on the left. So ideally for this case, the deformation should be limited to 0.3 mm. But in my case, with a provided thickness of 10 mm, the deformation is going up to 2.4 mm. Also on the base plate strain value, I have a value of 0.5%. So I definitely know I'm getting a very high deformation. Let's look at plastic strain. Ideally, there should be no strain. I have some amount of strain over here in my case. And let's also look at concrete stresses. So you can see, ideally, the concrete stresses should be limited to this portion, but I have some additional concrete stress and they are also going to a very high value. Now, what we discussed earlier is that if my plate is not rigid, then force on my anchor will increase. You can see the same thing happening over here. Ideally, the force on my anchor 1 and anchor 3 should be 25.5 kilonewton. But with a 10 mm thickness, I am getting a value of 42.6 kilonewton. So the anchor force variation is coming as 67%. And I also have a very high deformation. So if I click confirm, software will give me a warning. that the plate I am providing is not close to rigid. So what can I do to make this connection rigid? Option number one is to increase the plate thickness. Let's say I make the thickness of the plate as 14 mm. And changing the thickness is as easy as clicking on it and entering the value. I press calculate. So Chandru is just signaling me that we are overshooting on the time part. I hope it's okay if we overshoot by, let's say, 5-10 more minutes, but I want to cover this part. Now, if you see, by increasing the thickness, I have brought down my deformation to 1 mm from 2.4 mm. So thickness of the plate definitely has an effect on the rigidity. And also what you would see is plastic strain has disappeared. The concrete stress value has come down from 31 Newton per mm square to 12 Newton per mm square. But still, I see an anchor force variation of 23%. There is also a 0.2% of strain available. If I click confirm, software again gives me a warning. Now let's say I increase my thickness to 16 mm. And I also add a few stiffeners. So I go to the profile tab. I select from the layout that I want to provide two stiffeners. So you can see stiffeners have appeared. I have three options in shape: rectangular, triangular, or chamfered. Let's say I want to do a chamfered stiffener. I can define the sizes. I can also define the welds for stiffener. Let's say I want a two-sided fillet weld for my stiffeners. And then I recalculate. Now you see the difference. Deformation is still high. I'm getting a deformation of 0.8 mm. Concrete stresses have increased certain bit. They have gone up to 15. There is no plastic strain. But if you look at the anchor force variation, it has come down to 6%. Now this is where your engineering judgment comes into picture. Please understand, Profis Engineering is an analysis software which enables you to decide what is the right solution for your connection. So you might decide to accept a deformation of 0.8 mm. That is completely your call. If not, what we can do is, so now if I click confirm, the software does not give me a warning. If you are not happy with the 0.8 mm deformation, we can make it 18 mm thickness and we can quickly recheck what happens to the deformation because other parameters are within permissible limits. You can see anchor force variation has gone down to zero. I have a deformation of 0.7 mm. Concrete stresses have gone down to 13 mm. I have no additional stress, concrete stress on the sides, no plastic strain. I can click confirm and I can go back to the software and look at the diagrams again. So I can see the equivalent stress diagram. What is the actual value of stress where? I can look at the plastic strain. So no plastic strain. I can look at stresses in concrete and I can even check the deformation. And if I am not wrong, this deformation of 0.7 mm is coming at this location. So on the plate, the deformation is not going up to 0.7 mm. What I can also check is the utilization on my right. For anchors, I can see what is the utilization in tension, in shear, combination tension plus shear. I can see the values for base plate. So base plate, the stress value is going up to 208 Newton per mm square. Permissible is 273. I can see the whole bearing capacity. For welds, I have a utilization of 99%. If you want, you can increase the size of the weld. And I see some details for stiffeners. So I can see the one mice's stress value for stiffeners. It is going up to 206. So it is also within permissible limit. And I can see the load bearing concrete capacity, 30% utilization here. Profile, I can see the stress values again. Once I'm satisfied, everything looks green, I'm happy with the design, I can go ahead and generate a report. Now, yes, Chandru, I understand we are running out of time. I'll just quickly show a glimpse of the report and we can see if we have any questions. So you can see, like I said, 17-page detailed report, which has your anchor design part. You can see the formulas for steel failure here. You can see the reference of the code. You see the formula for pullout failure. You see concrete breakout, the calculation, formulas and codal reference. Pry out failure. So you see the complete installation data. So you see the profile, you see the hole diameter in fixture, hole diameter in the fixture for through fastening, plate thickness, what we have taken. We also see the anchor size, anchor number, anchor layout is clearly printed on the report, edge distance, everything. And now we come to the base plate design. So here you can see whatever input we have taken. And as an output, you get the anchor forces, the comparison equivalent and CBFEM, what we provided. You also see the equivalent stress for different components, for stiffeners, for profiles. You see the actual value, the strain value, the permissible, gamma m naught, the factor of safety that we take. So this is the permissible stress, permissible strain, all of it within permissible limit. So that is here. You also see the plastic strain value. You also see weld by weld, what is the utilization. In both the directions, parallel and perpendicular, what is the utilization? So welds for complete anchor plate weld and then welds for stiffeners. And this represents fillet weld of 4 mm. So this notation is for showing the type of weld. You also see the concrete stresses. And the symbols are explained at the end. And the report at the end says fastening meets the design criteria. You have the summary of results and the utilization of each of the element. So this is the complete report. And this was just a glimpse of the software. I understand, Chandru, we are running out of time. So just one second, I'll switch back to the presentation. So next we have some good features that were missing. So you can see we have now added an undo redo button. This was a miss from our side in Profis Anchor. What we have also done is made the report flexible. So you can see a flexible report. You can choose the type of report that you want. And you can even place your logo on the report. Now we have an option to add your logo to the report as well. Now, these are some of the things that we are working on. So we are working on a handrail design module, which will be coming in the future. Now, quantity calculator is something which we have already developed. So for the chemical anchors, Profis Engineering will enable you to calculate the quantity. And we are also in the process of developing an app for the contractor so that you can directly send your designs to the contractor on his app and he can do a thorough installation. This app will also have installation videos and guidelines so that installation happens as intended. Now, this is a picture which I wanted to show you, and let me also tell you that this picture has all Hilti employees in one frame. And I'm sure you have not seen my face, so let me tell you, I'm standing right here. That's me. Chandru, do you remember where you are?
No idea.
No idea. Chandru is lost in the crowd. So with this picture, I want to tell you, there are more than 100 people in the engineering team. Both Chandru and me are part of the engineering team. We have more than 65 field engineers who reach out to you and support you if you need some help regarding design or some help is required at site. We have 5 people in the codes and approvals team. We have 5 people in engineering competence center. And we have more than 500 people in our projects team. These are the people who visit job sites and take care of the installation part. They do trainings for contractor, they do demos, they make sure whatever you have designed is replicated by the contractor in the same way. And we as a team provide to you design to execution support right at your doorstep. And with that, I think I can tell you, with Profis Engineering coming in, these services, these support to you will even get better. And Chandru, I'll hand it over to you. Just one thing which I forgot to show everyone is just quickly I'll show in the software, we have an option to help you. So, okay, the software has come. So we have a support button here. So if you face any problem, you can reach out to us, or there is a Profis Engineering user manual available. So this manual has step-by-step instructions of what needs to be done in every case. So you can see this has 36 pages. And you can see on every topic, let's say, let me pick a topic. I want to define base material. So I click over there. I reach out to this part. It has step by step guidelines along with screenshots, which can help you to learn this software. We will definitely provide a training on a one-on-one basis in your office. But you also have this user manual available with you, which can help you to easily understand any of the new features of the software. And Chandru, I've taken a lot of your time, so I'll quickly switch back and I hand it over to you for questions.
Yeah. I see a lot of questions, but due to lack of time, we'll answer one or two questions over here, and the rest we'll post it in Ask Hilti, where it'll be posted with the answers. So let us go through a few of the questions which has been posted. Okay. So grout thickness, Sangmesh.
Okay. So there is a question if we can take into account the effect of grout thickness And the answer is yes, you can define the grout if you are using any of the grouts under the material. Then you can definitely define the grout.
Who else can access my design kept on cloud server? Only me or open to all? Ramesh Prasad.
Okay, so Mr. Ramesh has asked a question saying who all can access my design on the cloud servers. So I want to tell you that the cloud is accessible to all the users you give access to. So there are different versions of the software available. So we have a multi-user license under which you can give the software access to multiple people, and whoever has the access to a particular project will be able to use it. I see another question by Miss Amrita. Can we use box channel Indian sections? So the answer is if you want to use channel sections, let's say back to back or front to front. So if I talk about back to back, if I weld two channels, it becomes an I section. So what you can do is you can go to select I section and put a custom dimension. If, however, you want to create a box, you can select the box section. Let me quickly show you what I'm talking about. So under profiles, if I go, currently we have a limited number of profiles. Let's say you want to create a front to front channel section. In that case, what you can do is select a rectangular hollow section because you are any which way forming a box. Click on this part, click on custom, and then define the dimensions here. So this is one way you can take care of channel sections with box, or be it you are doing it back to back to make an eye. Yes, Chandru is asking me to end this session, but let me take one last question, Chandru. Okay. So there is one question by Mr. Gautam, who is asking how about the cracked uncracked condition selection. Will it be same drop down option that has to be selected manually like in Profis Anchor? Okay, so if I talk about cracked uncracked section, if I go to my base material, there is an option cracked concrete. So if you check it, it becomes it is you are doing a cracked concrete design. If you uncheck it, it becomes an uncracked concrete. But sir, I would like to tell you here that as per IS code, 0.3 mm cracks are allowable in the concrete if we are doing it through limit state method, and all concrete should be considered as cracked concrete. Don't you agree, Chandru?
Very true, very true. Everything is a cracked concrete.
Chandru, can I do one last question?
Yeah, let us make this as a final question. So
okay, so the final question that I'll take is from Miss Megha Kashyap. She has asked, can we design base plate on vertical or shear wall? Ma'am, the answer is a definite yes. So what needs to be done is you have to model it in a way that it becomes a wall. So let's say if let's consider this as a slab and I have a tension load. So I put it here, shear loads here. But if let's say you have a wall, you can do a similar thing. The representation will look similar, but you can enter the load inputs in such a way that it represents a wall. What I mean by that is you only need to take care of the load directions. We can even do it for a column, let's say, or a beam. Let's say I have a beam and I'm fixing the plate on the side. So I can make these two edges as finite, and this becomes a beam. So you can see I have a beam which is continuous on both these sides, and I'm fixing a plate on the side. So all the concrete members, be it pedestal, be it column, slab, raft, foundation, only the modeling part will change. And I see there are a lot of questions. I'll definitely answer each of them and the answers will reach out to you. Maybe Chandru can explain more on this. And thank you for listening to this webinar. I want to thank you for attending and engaging with me. All of you responded very well on the polls. I thank you again and I hand it over to Chandru.
Yeah, let's quickly finish this actually. So I think all of you are interested in going for lunch. It's about lunchtime. So a lot of questions have come in the questions tab. So what we'll do is we'll go and ask Hilti. So most people, I think, will be available or known about this link of Hilti, which is called ask.hilti.in. If not, please log in this particular page where we have three different options, wherein there is an ask column, wherein wherever you're having a question, you can post your questions over there. And in our present webinar, whatever questions were which has arisen, we will post it on the ask part and we will answer it as well, so that the question and answer both will be a part of it. And the second column, which is a webinar part. So this webinar, which we are currently presenting, will be completely recorded and it will be posted in this webinar column, so that any attendees who joined later during the call or who want to go through it again on a later stage, you can go through this in this particular section. And the third part, articles. So there are a lot of articles which is posted from our end. And as you can rightly see, there is something called rigid base plate, probably the most underrated aspect of a steel to concrete connection design. So these articles are also posted, which gives us a better background or whatever innovations is happening in the market and how things are getting better. So along with this, I would like to end this session and we thank you all for attending the webinar and participating in the polls, questionnaire and everything. I hope everything was good to your concern. So thank you all. Thank you. So there is a survey which is which will be posted to you. So kindly fill up the survey and we'll get back. Thank you.